Dining should be about bringing people together. And to be able to eat off 18th century porcelain, which is the passion of many of the people around this table tonight, will be a special privilege.
I'm Tom Kemble. I'm the head chef of Bonham's Restaurant. So having looked at these Brion cups, immediately I was thought of, you know, a smaller Lamuse, that they're small cups, they don't need to take much. And I think the Velouté was quite a modern representation of using them in a slightly different way. The amuse-bouche is a Jerusalem artichoke velouté. It's a very silky, voluptuous soup finished with black truffle, which has just come into season now.
Well, this is a unique opportunity. You have a French service from the 18th century that we're allowed to have dinner on. That's how services should be used, I think. They come alive when you use them. They weren't made just for show. They were made to dine. And it's wonderful to have that opportunity. We can't do that with museum collections.
The starter is a scallop carpaccio. This is a very visual dish. You've got really bright, intense greens. And I think looking at the porcelain, it will really work well with what we have.
This service comes to us directly through the descendants of Baron van Nagel, who was a very highly placed nobleman in Holland. And the family actually used this service every year for Christmas. So it's nice to know that there is a continuation of almost 230 years of constant use of this service.
It's typical of the 18th century when they're still dining in the French manner. The food is set on the table and people serve themselves. So you have all kinds of shapes and dishes for special food types.
This is a really refreshing way for a chef personally now to play. I mean, to have the opportunity to play off these 18th century ceramics is a delight.
You also understand what workmen and what the factory's ideas were behind making these services. There had to be a surprise. Often when you drank from a cup and you lifted it from its saucer, you saw a different display again, you saw a different decoration. And the same is the case for this service. If you look at the detail of the saucières, for example, with their beautiful curved handles, it's sort of a sensory experience.
There's just kind of functional things like how deep a bowl is or how flat a plate is, whether the sauce of a main course, for example the venison, whether that sinks to the bottom and you can scoop it up with your spoon.
It's a time period in the Netherlands in the 18th century when the French invade the Netherlands, and we see two sides, the House of Orange, the Orangist, and the Patriotic movement. You could illustrate a whole history from the past, but also the current situation. These dining tables were political.
Tom is actually going back to the 18th century in the dessert dish particularly, because he's using the original ice cream pails, which would have been really used to hold ice cream, which was then very precious and very hard to keep.
I hope we can engage other people to see how much more value it gives to your dinner to have such a historic piece to dine from.